So in this screencast, we're going to talk about how to communicate from the child thread with the main thread. And basically what we are going to use to enable this kind of communication is a construct called handler. Okay, and that handler is like a mailbox that the child thread can deposit messages that actually arrive at the main thread. Okay, and then the main thread is able to read these messages by accessing that mailbox. Okay, so basically it's straightforward. Let's say, how do we create that handler? So it's called handler. Okay, and call it handler. Okay, so basically this is the handler. And it might ask you to import a class. So basically, if you typed it for the first time, it will ask you to import the class. You could do Alt Enter, and it will show you import the class. And it is the Android OS package. Okay, so that's the handler. Okay, so let's remove this. Okay. So that's the handler. Now, how do you instantiate the handler? We say handler dot equals new handler. Okay, and then basically the constructor that we will use is a constructor that would require a callback. Okay, let's say if we did it again, you could see there is one of them that will actually require a callback. So basically new callback, and basically that's it. Okay, and you can see the callback is an interface that we have to implement, and it has one method inside it. It's called handle message, and you can see that the parameter that is being passed is message. Very nice. And we look at this return value. For the time being, return value false means that it has not been handled by the main activity, and you would like also to use the default behavior of the handler to be executed. This means that this handle message is going to be executed, plus the handle message of the handle itself is going to be executed. You can return true. In that case, you would say that I'm done with handling messages at this level, and it will not be trickled down to the main activity or the main thread or the main handler to handle it again. Okay, we'll look at this in a little bit, but this is where the message is going to be handled. Okay, so basically you receive a message and you handle it. So now let's look at the runnable. We have to do work. Let's say the outer loop will go 100 times, okay? And then there is an inner loop that does some work. And then here we have the handler, and I could say send message. So let's say I'll just simply send an empty message just to show that there is a message that's being sent. So let's say I'll send an empty message, and I'll always say 100. That's a simple message that I'm going to send. And then here I will say log.d, and I'll say demo. And I'll say that message received, right? Okay, so basically that's just to indicate that the message has been received. And there is start work and there is end work. Okay, so let's run it. So basically that what's going to happen is, let's say thread. We need to schedule the thread, right? New, do work, and then we'll say start. Okay, basically that would schedule this work, and this work actually will print out this message, and then it will loop for 100 times, and then inside each loop there is this a little bit of work that it's doing, and then after this little bit of work is being done, there is a message that's going to be sent, and it has 100 inside it. Okay, forget about the 100 for the time being, but you're sending an empty message. This means that there is something that's going to get deposited in that mailbox, and then that method is going to be called, and then we're going to print this message. Okay, cool. So let's run it. We'll do this. Okay. Here it is, and look at the Android monitor, and then boom, here it is. So basically what we are having here is message received, message received, message received. Okay, and okay, let me delete this. We'll run it again, just to get an idea. Okay, here we go. So basically we have, let me change the text a little bit so that it is easier for you to see it. So let's say message received dot 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 dot, so that you could see that this is coming in from this, not from a previous test. I'll put these dots just to indicate that this is the new messages. Okay, we go back. We go to the Android monitor, and you could see here that there is start work. Okay, and then there is messages that are being received, messages that are being received, messages that are being received. And you could see here that end work has been printed, but here there are still messages that are being received. Actually, what happens is it's a queue, right? So even though the thread has done its work, right? But every time it says handle message, sends a message, what's happening is that it's depositing a message into the queue. So you see the queue is full. And then even though it's ended its messages, these messages were deposited earlier. And that's why they are being printed here, okay? So now let's say we want to send an actually meaningful message. So what you could do is you could create a message. Okay, equal new message. Okay, so basically it's a new message, and then you could see this message has something called what. You see it has some parameter called what, and it's an integer. Okay, that what is basically a status parameter. That's usually some number. It's an integer that actually indicates your status. Okay, and I'm going to use it to indicate how far I am in the outer loop. So I'll just make it equal to I, and then here instead of just sending 100, I'll say message. And then instead of doing it, so basically I need to send a message, right? So basically I'm not going to send an empty message. I'll say send message, right? And I'm going to pass a message. Okay. So basically I'm going to send a message coming here. Now I would like to print that number, and basically it's very straightforward. I will say message dot what, right? So that's basically, I'm just going to print the what that I'm going to send in the message. Okay, so let's run this again. Okay, let's look at the Android monitor, and you can see here I'm printing out the numbers. Okay, cool. So I think things are showing up as we expected, right? And you could see here these are the numbers, and then these are basically what is being printed out from the what. Okay, now there is also in the message, there's something called message. You can also send inside the message an object. Okay, so basically instead of sending I here, I could say this is the object, and it's just an object. So basically I want to send I, but I is an integer. So basically let's say I'll send it as an integer. Integer. Okay, just to make sure that it's going to be sent as an integer. Okay, and then so I'm casting it, but just to make sure, because this is an object, then when I go back here to retrieve it, I could say message dot dot object, or I could say get data, or sorry, message dot object, right? And then that's the object that we are getting, and it's an integer, right? So basically that's something to look at. So basically it's an integer. Now if you go back to the Android monitor, it's the same story, right? We're still printing the same number, the I that we are sending. Okay, so now again, so what is usually a status, right? So basically let's keep it as a status. So basically what we can do is let's create the status static final integers, and that's going to be, say for example, status start equals 0x00, so that's the start message, and then I'll have a status, say stop, or say progress, and then I have another one which is stop, and then one of them is going to be 1, the other one is 0, 1, 2, right? So basically what we could do is we can send messages, right? Oh, I need some power. Let me insert the power plug. Okay. All right, we have power now. Okay, so basically what we could do is we can send these messages, right? Basically what we can do is maybe we can create these messages, right? I'll create a message here when we are starting. Right, then you create a new message, and okay, and all I'm going to signify at the beginning is what. So basically we'll say, we can call this start message, for example, right? And what is going to be status start, and then becomes the message. Okay, good. So that's a send message when we start, and then we'll send another one when we are done. The same story, instead of printing the stuff here. Okay, let's remove that stuff, and then here we'll call this the stop message. Okay, that's the stop message, and then this one is the stop. Okay, we're just sending what's in here, and then here we are going to say this is status progress, and then when we're sending a progress, we're going to send stuff like this. Okay, so now what we could do is when we are receiving messages here, we could have a switch statement, switch over what, message dot what, right? That's my switch statement, and I could say case when it is what, when it say status, or we could say do work dot status status start, right? Okay, so that's for the start, we're doing something, and then for the stop we'll do something, and then for the progress we'll do something else. That's stop, and then this is progress. Okay, cool. So basically what we could do is we can do stuff like this. We could say starting, right? So here we could say starting, right? And then that's basically starting process, and then we have the stopping process. This is the stopping, and then here there is a progress, and then the progress we are expecting that there is going to be an object that has an integer inside it, right? So basically we'll say message dot obj, and that's basically what we are going to print. Okay, so basically what we did is we're creating these status values that signify where are you in the process, either you're starting or you're stopping or you have some progress to notify. And basically we are looping 100 times from 0 to 99, and then inside there is some work that we are doing, and then basically we're sending a message when the work is done. Okay, so we run it, look at the Android monitor, and that's what we're getting. See, if you look here, we are getting starting, right? And then we can see there is some progress happening, and then there is the end, which is stopping. Okay, you could see now how this how we are using this handler to communicate back and forth back from the child thread to the main thread, right? Okay, so let's say is it only limited to sending message objects? No, you can also send. What you could do is there is something that we can create, which is called a bundle. So you can create a bundle, okay, and you say bundle equal new bundle, which is very similar to the extras, okay? And then inside the bundle you could say add, sorry, dot put integer. Okay, you can put an integer, you just have to have a string. Okay, so basically let's create a string which is the key and value pair. So basically we could say progress key, right? And we'll call it, and that's a string. Okay, cool. So that's the progress key, right? So basically it's going to be an integer progress key, and it's going to be this. Okay, so let's remove the obj. I'm not going to send it in the obj. I'm going to send it inside the bundle, and then basically what we could do is we could say message add data, or put data, sorry, set data. Here it is, set data. Okay, and you pass it the bundle, and then basically this is very similar to extras, right? You're passing it some data, you can add other stuff too, not only an integer. You can add doubles, you can add other strings and so on. You add it to the bundle, you add it to the message. Now when you are here, instead of printing it like this, you say dot get data dot get integer, and you pass it the key, which is going to be do work dot progress key. Okay, so basically we are not going to use the obj, the object. Instead I'm going to pass it into a bundle. Okay, so we run it again. All right, same story, we're getting the same numbers again and so on. Now let's have some fun. Let's say we want to display a progress dialog that shows up what shows us what we are doing here, right? So let's say progress dialog. I'll create a progress dialog. Okay, progress dialog. I created as a global variable here, or a variable at the class level, because I want this do work to have access to it. Because do work, because this is a UI component, the do work should never touch it. I want to access it here. Okay, so I'll create a variable that holds the progress dialog, and then we go from there. Okay, so basically when you are starting, what we will do is we'll say, we'll set up the progress dialog here. Progress dialog equal new progress dialog. Okay, so that creates the progress dialog. Actually, I think it needs a context. It needs a context. So we'll say it's the min activity dot this. Okay, that's the progress dialog. Okay, you can even create the progress dialog at the activity level if you want to do it here, even before the handler is created. You could do this. So that's the progress dialog being created. You can even set it up. Progress dialog dot set. We could set message, for example. the message for it, we could say updating progress, or even we could say doing work or something like that. Okay, so that's the message that's going to appear, and then we say progress dialog.set maximum to 100, so it will go up to 100. And notice here that we just loop from 0 to 100, actually, so 0 to 99, so it's 100 steps, right? And then basically that's set maximum, and then the default progress dialog is circular. Okay, so basically we'll say progress dialog dot set progress, I think, style, progress style, and then you say progress dialog style as horizontal, and then progress dialog dot set cancelable to false. So that's that progress dialog is already set up, but it's not apparent, right? It's not visible. So what we could do here, we say progress dialog dot set progress when you're starting, we'll set set progress to 0, right? And then we'll say progress dialog dot show. Okay, that's when you are starting. Now when you are ending, we'll say progress dialog dot dismiss. Okay, and then here when you are changing your progress, we'll say progress dialog dot set progress to what? We'll say that's your progress. Here's your progress, which is the value that's coming in from the message. Okay. Okay, so we can run this and try. So let's run it. Okay, I noticed that if you go here and look, the messages are showing up, but the progress is not showing. I think what's happening is that the progress is showing, but it's showing very quickly. So this means that it's this loop is just very small, so it executes really fast, and we cannot see the progress. Actually, the progress shows, it moves its progress and it disappears. So let's add more zeros, we'll add more two zeros, and then run it again, and then you will see, so you're adding a little bit more work here, so that delays a little bit what's happening, and you could see here the updating progress is happening. Now let's see, will it dismiss? So it's moving. And you can see that it will reach 99 and then it will stop. It never reaches 100, right? Why it doesn't reach 100? Because we're looping from 0 to 99. So probably we'll just need to bump up this number by 1, right? Okay, cool. So you could see what is happening. We have worked with the progress. We can set the progress initially to 0 if we want. And we have demoed using OBG to pass data, or passing it in a bundle that is actually inserted into the message. I hope this was useful. Please let me know if you have any questions. Thank you.